For the international events and the adaptive events will be held later on in this afternoon session. It's GB and the Netherlands crossing the line, and then it's those two crews who will qualify for the final A in this event. Brazil will take third, then Korea, then Japan.
France, thank you very much indeed. Yes, Great Britain too coming home in first place there. 7:24.64 their winning time. Netherlands taking the second spot in the A final, 7:25.95. Great Britain and the Netherlands were absolutely neck and neck even down to the 100th of a second at 1500 metres. But by the end, Great Britain had taken 1.3 seconds out of the Dutch. It's Great Britain 2 and Netherlands who go to final A.
Auch in diesem zweiten Hoffnungslauf waren wieder zwei Plätze für das A-Finale zu vergeben. Mit einer Zeit von 7 Minuten und 24 Sekunden geht mit dem ersten Platz in diesem Rennen eins der beiden Tickets an das Boot von Großbritannien, gerudert von Imogen Welsh und Andrea Dennis. Auf dem zweiten Platz mit einer Sekunde Abstand dahinter das Boot aus den Niederlanden, gerudert von Rianne Siegmund und Maike Head.
Next up then we have the first semi-final of the lightweight men's double sculls. There are six crews on the water and the first three will go through to final A. The lineup is this. Poland are in lane one. Then Hungary, Erling and Varga are in two. New Zealand, Stormuru and Peter Taylor, the silver medalists in Lucerne, are in three. Then it's the Olympic medalists from 2008 representing Denmark, Rasmussen and Quist in four. Mendes and Fraga of Portugal in five, Sayers and Mayol of Argentina are in six. Poland, Hungary, New Zealand, Denmark, Portugal, Argentina looking for three places in the A final. And watching this one for us, Tanya and Sebastian.
Yes, indeed, and Mahe Dreisel is still with us, so 700 meters into this race, he'll be delighted to see Stormuru and Peter Taylor competing with the Danish for first place, just a meter separating both crews, and also the Hungarians sitting there three quarters of a length down on the leading pack. And then it's the Portuguese, the former European bronze medalist, who try to maintain or regain an overlap rather with the Hungarians, and then already a length and a half down we see the Argentinians in fifth and Poland in sixth position. So the field already splitting up very early. The first three might pull away a little bit more as we come to the further stages of this race.
Ja, es ist noch nicht einmal ganz die Hälfte absolviert in diesem ersten Halbfinale zum Leichtgewichtsmänner-Zweier und schon zieht sich das Feld auseinander. Die Dänen führen mit einem Luftkastenvorsprung vor Neuseeland, beide schon bei Olympia 2008 am Start. Und die Dänen waren es, die dort die Bronzemedaille gewonnen haben und sie liegen, wie gesagt, mit einem Vorsprung von einem Luftkasten vorne. Dann an dritter Position im Moment die Ungarn, die bei der Olympischen Qualifikationsregatta in Luzern gewannen und sich somit in letzter Sekunde für die Teilnahme an den Olympischen Spielen qualifiziert haben. Portugal, Argentinien und Polen sind im Moment auf den Plätzen 4, 5 und 6 unterwegs.
Good race still for the Danish. It's just a meter ahead of Kiwi crew, and it has been like this for the last 300-400 meters. The Portuguese in fourth position have not managed to get closer to the Hungarians, so the leading trio is still there. It's the Danish trying to hold on to first place, but while I'm telling you this, it's Stormuru and Peter Taylor, the silver medalist of last year, bronze medal the year before. So what do you think, Maher, will be their expectations or hope for this year?
Yeah, they've been pretty fired up this year. Obviously last year I think it hurt them a lot. They beat the British during the week and then lost in the final. So, you know, they've been training pretty hard, and I think they're now just starting to show out in front of the Danes, which is, this is probably the strong part of their race.
We'll see the British double of Zach Purchase and Mark Hunter in the other semi-finals to come up in a minute. Denmark and New Zealand level pegging. It's not much to choose. It's Baobao to Baobao here with 600 meters to go. another great semi-final, but this is for the record books only, because I mean all three crews look set to qualify, because just a canvas separating the leading three crews, the former world champions from Hungary, also back in form, Scholt Hirling and Tamás Varga back to form and try to challenge the Kiwis for first place. Denmark still hanging in second, and then it's way back for the Portuguese, the Polish double and the Argentinian double, so that may be four or five lengths even more for all three boats. So it's really a two split field here, two sections of this race, and it's the Kiwis that now try to take charge of this race. A canvas for the New Zealand double ahead of Denmark, who desperately try to maintain there, stay there and maintain speed, I would like to say. 300 meters to go, and it's New Zealand leading Denmark, then Hungary, and both are nearly level.
Die letzten 250 Meter brechen an und die gehen zuerst für die Neuseeländer in Erfüllung, denn sie haben jetzt eine Länge Vorsprung herausgerudert. Storm Euro und Peter Taylor haben auf den letzten 100 Metern ordentlich aufgedreht und die Dänen fast stehen lassen und auch die Ungarn sind herangekommen. Doch alle drei Boote qualifizieren sich ja fürs Finale morgen am Sonntag. Die weiteren Boote aus Portugal, Polen und Argentinien sind abgeschlagen und werden morgen das B-Finale bestreiten.
What a mighty push from the New Zealand crew. Storm Euro Peter Taylor managed to pull away just over a length now with about 12-15 strokes to the line. It's the lightweight men's doubles semi-final number one, and it's a great performance by the Kiwis, but the more so from the Hungarians, because they managed to come from behind to overtake the leading Danish crew. They have been the early showers in this race and led for half of the race of the distance, so coming towards the finish line, the semi-final number one is won by New Zealand ahead of Hungary, and then Denmark. All will be rowing together in the final eight tomorrow.
Three places up for grabs then to the A final of the lightweight men's double sculls. New Zealand coming through safely there, 6:37.22 the winning time for Uru and Taylor, looking to improve on that silver medal in Lucerne. 6:38.96 for Hungary in second place, who judged their race very nicely, moving through from third to second in the closing 200 or 300 meters. And Denmark, who were up thereabouts, leading in fact at 1,000 meters, eventually relegated to third, but safely through to the A final nonetheless. Their time 6:41.22. New Zealand, Hungary and Denmark progress to final A.
Auch im Halbfinale der Leichtgewichtsdoppelzweier der Männer setzt sich die Erfolgsserie der neuseeländischen Ruderer fort auf dem ersten Platz mit einer Zeit von 6 Minuten und 37 Sekunden liegen Storm Uru und Peter Taylor, und mit ihnen zusammen ziehen zwei weitere Boote in das A-Finale ein. Es sind diese auf dem zweiten Platz mit einer Zeit von 6 Minuten und 38 Sekunden, somit ein Rückstand von einer Sekunde und 7 Zehntel, das Boot aus Ungarn, und auf dem dritten Platz auf Bahn 4 das Boot aus Dänemark.